It's an invitation to my birthday tomorrow. I hope you'll be able to make it to the party.
I'll kill you. One more to go.
Hey, what's up, guys? So, yeah, I just finished watching the very first episode of Gundam Wing, and, you know, I came into this series with an open mind. I tried to ignore all the criticism this series has received, and I just wanted to watch this episode and get my own, you know, feelings for it. And after I watched it, I felt pretty weird. Like, I felt like I didn't really get that much of a true understanding of the episode itself. Like, I really did try hard to understand the episode, but something like Operation Meteor and just a bunch of moments of Heero being, I don't even know how to describe it, kind of weird and crazy. And I knew Heero was kind of like a serious guy, but like, my thoughts on Heero changed from serious dude to just fucking crazy as shit. Like, I thought Mikazuki was kind of crazy, and you know, I actually decided to watch Wing because of Iron-Blooded Orphans, because people compared it to Wing or something, or they compared Mikazuki to Heero, so, you know, I decided to watch Wing to kind of see how Heero is. And honestly, this is just really weird how he acted. So I'm going to tell you guys like three different things I believe that was just the most hilarious shit in this entire episode. So it first starts off in the beginning of the episode, actually, with Heero fighting two mobile suits, and he kills them, and then he just starts laughing. He's just like, oh my goodness. He was just laughing like some kind of game or something. I was like, holy shit, man. This dude is kind of out there, you know? And another good part is with Relina. Now, this was absolutely the most hilarious part of this entire episode. Like, she sees Heero on the beach. Like, he just washes on shore or something. He's, like, passed out. She's like, oh, human, let me go see what's up, you know? He takes off his mask, and she's like, it's a boy. And then Heero wakes up. He's like, oh, shit, what the fuck? An ambulance is there. He's like, oh, God, I'm gonna get caught. And he, like, jumps back, acts like some kind of savage barbarian or something, flips a little switch on his suit, blows himself up. Nothing happened. He's just like, oh, God, it didn't work. Let me just run away now. He walks up the stairs, just roundhouse kicks this one guy, and just beats the shit out of these other two guys, and just steals the ambulance and drives off. So I was just like, what just happened? Like, what just happened? And then at the end of the scene where he drives off in the stolen ambulance, you see Relina just holding her hand. She's like, my name is Relina. What's your name? I was just like, dude, this is kind of awkward. Like, what? I was just kind of speechless there. You know, I didn't know what to even think about that. And then let me talk about one of the most savage-ass scenes I have ever seen in Gundam. So, she invites Heero to her birthday party because it's coming up and whatnot. You know, it's kind of cool. And he takes the envelope, puts both of his hands on it, rips it in her face, and then she just starts crying, and I was just like, what? And then, like you can see the tears, like, starting to come out. And then you see Heero place his finger below her eyelids, wipes them off, and just flicks it off. And I love how the tears were just, like, so focused in the scene, like, that you could actually just see them. And it's just like, what? And then she says, why? And he's like, I'll kill you. I'm just like, okay, buddy. Okay, there we go. And that's all I needed to see and experience to get a good idea of what Heero Yui is like. And I think I got a good bit of scenes to just bring up a good little thing for him to think about now when I compare him to other Gundam protagonists. Honestly, this episode was not really, well, I didn't find it boring, but it was just entertaining. Entertaining in the sense of just all the hilarious shit that I've just saw and explained in this video. I didn't really think of it as a, you know, serious Gundam or Gundam series, judging from this episode itself. Many other Gundam series did a better job of, like, you know, introducing the series, such as 00, and even watching, like, the first episode of Unicorn Gundam. Like, I was just, you know, really really driven to understand like what kind of environment the protagonist is in. Like in Wing, I don't even know, man. Like I was just watching the episode of Wing, and I never really, I didn't really care. Like I honestly didn't care about it. They were just like Operation Meteor, and it's just a bunch of utter random shit. And then you just see Heero acting like a savage, and you see all the five Gundams coming out of nowhere, and just doing a whole bunch of weird shit. And by the way, guys, I was watching the English dub of this episode, if that will help gather up a bit of relation to what I experienced, because honestly, the English dub was okay. Like, I'm putting like an okay, flat okay, like 5 out of 10 okay. It wasn't amazing, it wasn't terrible, but there were some moments where I was just like, wow, they actually really released this. But I mean, compared to other animes during that time, I suppose it was alright for English dub, and it was also the Blu-ray version as well. But I mean, Hero's voice actor just seems emotionless. Like there's no, you know, he just doesn't have that, you know, emotional expression in his voice. It's just like, I don't know, man. Like, do you guys know what I'm talking about? Because I'm trying really hard to just explain this, but it's kind of hard. Like, he's like really emotionless. I'm not sure if that's intended, but it's just kind of weird, you know? But anyways, I just got a pretty good laugh out of this episode. I will try to finish the series itself so I can get a better understanding of it overall. But with, you know, how college is and whatnot, I'll have to manage my time better to, you know, get in all these anime episodes of Gundam from Iron-Blooded Orphans, Wing. And I think I might want to start actually watching probably Victory as well, because people have said that it was pretty violent for a series. And, you know, I love violent series. I watched Tokyo Ghoul, even though it wasn't really that violent as people have said it to be, but it was kind of gory. It was kind of cool. But as in like violent, people said like people die so much in the series itself, so I'm not sure if I should really want to be going in there with a mindset of I'm gonna be, you know, I'll be like attached to this one character, I hope he doesn't die. But I'm pretty sure like, if I go in with that mindset, I'm gonna be disappointed. So just go in with a blank slate. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoy this pretty funny video of me just, you know, expressing my feelings about Heero Yui, basically. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, and please tell me how you guys feel about Wing. I really want to hear what other people think about Wing itself, because I've heard many, many opinions about this series, and I really want to know what you guys are feeling, because what I'm feeling right now is probably different from what you guys are feeling. But anyways, I'll see you guys later. Thank you for watching. My 落ちる花、ビラ開け